Hi, I'm Adena Bank-Lees, and this is The Power of Experiential Learning. Pamela, as in the role of mother, covertly incestuous relationship with your son, give me three adjectives.
Needy, lonely, inappropriate.
Needy, lonely, inappropriate. Okay, just hold that for a second, okay? And Deb, in role of father, three adjectives.
I'm angry, I'm lonely, and I'm needy.
Angry, lonely, needy.
Yeah.
Okay, so Kenny, what I want you to do is to just experience what you are going to experience from these two people. And all of you, I'd like you to pay attention to your bodies and what's happening in your bodies, what your emotions are, and any thoughts that come to you when you're in the role. Okay? We're just going to hold the roles for just a little bit, and when I say action, I'd like you to move your body in a way that depicts those adjectives in relationship to your son. Okay?
Okay.
Action.
Kenny, I need you.
Kenny, I'm the one who needs you.
Kenny, don't leave me, Kenny. I need you here.
Kenny, what are you doing over there? I want you here.
Kenny, here.
I have a lot going on at work. I need someone to talk to.
I have no one else.
No good for me.
I have no one else. Your father has work. All of his friends at work.
Okay, stop. Take your hands down. Take a breath. So, Kenny, in role of child, body sensations, emotions, thoughts.
Well, I felt a deep clenching in my stomach and that kind of pressure in the chest, very anxious. I felt really not in my body. I felt lost. I felt desperate. I felt unable to connect to my own experience, lost.
Lost, unable to connect to your own experience, anxious.
Yeah.
Okay. Not in your body.
Not in my body.
Okay. Great. Thank you. Thank you. Pamela, in role of mother.
I too felt anxious. I could feel butterflies in my stomach, some shortness of breath. When he turned toward his father, I felt desperate, and that I experienced through an increase of the anxiety feeling. I felt like I had to up the ante in order to get his attention back.
Can I interrupt you for a second?
Sure.
I also saw that upping the ante, you grabbed him harder.
Mm-hmm.
So physically, there was an urge
right.
to do something.
Right.
Okay.
And when I was doing that, I could also, there's a part of my head that was saying, this is really inappropriate. And I am desperate for that connection with him because I felt so disconnected from.
So I couldn't stop myself.
I couldn't stop myself even knowing that I was putting him in a difficult position. But I was desperate.
Okay.
Needy.
Needy, desperate,
isolated, alone.
So, Deb, in role of father, physical sensations, emotions, thoughts.
I, too, was feeling anxious. I felt like there was a clutch in my solar plexus, and I could feel anger rising through my body, feeling warm, not a pleasant warmth,
okay,
all the way up to my face. I was desperately wanting him, my son, to meet my own needs, and I was afraid that wasn't going to happen. I was also angry that he was connected to mom rather than me, and really wanting to control that.
Okay, and I saw that too with your hand on him. I really need you. So
yes.
A physical urge again.
Absolutely.
To reach out and do that.
When you're doing experiential learning, you get to hear and experience other people's feelings and recognize that those feelings are oftentimes similar, if not exactly the same, as the feelings that you have. And I think that's so vitally important because it gives a basis for the therapist then to begin the work. As a therapist, one of the expressions that I so appreciate is that all feelings will get expressed one way or another. So if we're not able to talk about them, we're acting them out. And we all act out feelings. And they maybe get acted out differently, but the base of the feelings are the same. And I think, again, as a therapist, that's vitally important to know. And as the clients in this particular role, the mother and the father, what a gift to hear that they were both experiencing the same things. And that's the beginning point of being able to draw these people together.